I welcome all the participants to this one day online orientation course on new engineering materials on behalf of Department of Science and Humanities and E.R. Perumal Manimegalai College of Engineering. We are happy to host you to this one day online course. So during this course, we are going to discuss some of the materialistic property of new engineering materials. So material engineering or material science is an interdisciplinary study where we are discussing large materialistic properties and their applications. In material science perspectives, these engineering materials are broadly classified into two groups. One is metals, another one is non-metal groups. During this course, we are going to discuss some classes of non-metallic group of engineering materials. I hope this discussion will give you some basic understanding on these materials at least. During this course, we will discuss different perspectives on different category of materials. In this juncture, I would like to thank all my staff members, management, and dear participants for spending your valuable time in this course. Now let us go into the discussion. So as we discussed, in engineering materials, there will be large discussions on large studies on different kind of materials to retrieve some required property or to improve the materials characteristics. So we have large number of discussions on metallic group of engineering materials. So as I told you earlier, in this course we are going to talk about more on non-metallic engineering materials. Now let us see what are all the important perspectives of the course. So engineering materials are the class of new materials which exhibits interesting properties comparing to the conventional one. So these kind of materials are made from our laboratories to fulfill some of our desires. It may be efficiency, it may be a cost effective one, or it may be developed to make these things available everywhere or in order to satisfy the growing technical needs. So under these conditions, in the current course, we are going to have the glimpses of ceramics, composites, metallic glasses, shape memory alloys, and nanomaterials. In all these topics, we will have our observations on different areas. I welcome everyone to this course and wish you all the best for this one day program. Thank you. Now let us continue our discussion on the topic ceramics. So what is ceramics? Ceramics are inorganic compounds of metallic and non-metallic elements. They are bonded together mainly by ionic or covalent bonds. They may form crystalline or it may exist in non-crystalline or mixture of both forms. These ceramics are generally known as clay products. Some of the important examples are silicas, the silicon dioxide, the main ingredient in most glass products, alumina, the aluminium oxide, used in various applications from abrasives to artificial bones, and hydrous aluminium silicate, the main ingredient in most clay products. So, the general properties of ceramic materials: they have high hardness, they are highly electrical insulators, and they are highly thermal insulators. They are chemically stable and they will have high melting point, which makes this material find applications in many thermal related activities. They are highly brittle, it shows no ductility. This causes problem in both processing and performance of the ceramic products. Some ceramics are transparent in nature, so which is useful for producing window glasses, which makes them a clear and cheapest material. The density of these ceramics are comparatively low comparing to metals, and they show high wear resistance, and ceramics are having high corrosion resisting material, high resisting properties. So these ceramics expose the good application in chemical industries also. So now let us see the various types of ceramics. Ceramics, based on their processing technique and raw material it is being processed and the area of application, these ceramics are classified into three main categories. Fundamentally, they are classified into three main categories. They are traditional ceramics, new ceramics or advanced ceramics, and third is glass ceramics. So the traditional ceramics are the clay products such as pottery and bricks, common abrasives and cement. These are all the good example of clay products, which comes under the category of traditional ceramics. The new ceramics are more recently developed ceramics based on oxides, carbides, etc., and generally possessing mechanical or physical properties superior or unique compared to traditional ceramics. And glass ceramics is a third category of ceramic material, which is mostly made up of silicon oxide, and it is largely differed from ordinary glass by their crystalline nature. We all know that glass is a very good example for amorphous nature, but by heat treating the glass material, a glass can be converted into glass ceramics, which has some crystallinity comparing to our normal glass. So glasses transformed into largely crystalline structure by heat treatment, such ceramics are called glass ceramics. Let us see properties and some interesting information about these type of ceramics one by one. First, let us take traditional ceramics. So it is the product produced based on mineral silicates, silica and mineral oxide found in nature. Primary products are fired clay, such as pottery, tableware, brick and tiles, cement, and natural abrasives such as aluminum. Products and the process to make them date back thousands of years. So we are using these traditional ceramics date back from thousands of years. Glass is also a silicate ceramic material and is sometimes included among traditional ceramics. So clay, silica, alumina are the raw material for traditional ceramics. Clay, these are all mineral silicates of various compositions. Silica, such as quartz, the most abundant substance in the nature, and alumina is the solid crystalline compound, have been formed and mixed in the earth crust over billions of years by complex geological. So these are all the product comes out of traditional ceramics, such as pottery and tile, tableware, brick and tile, refractories, abrasives. So these are all the ceramics we are using in our household activities day to day. Next is the next category is the new ceramic or advanced ceramics. So these are all the type of ceramics or class of ceramics developed synthetically over the last 7 decades. The term also refers to improvement in processing technique that provides greater control over structure and properties of ceramic materials. In general, new ceramics are based on compounds other than variation of aluminium silicate, which form most of the traditional ceramic materials. New ceramics are usually simpler chemically than traditional ceramics. For example, these are all oxides, carbides, nitrides and borides. So when we forming this ceramic material with the help of oxidizing carbides, nitrides and borate, they will show you better and improved characteristics comparing to the traditional ceramic material. So these are all some of the applications or product out of advanced ceramic product. So we are using abrasives for grinding wheel grits and other hard ceramic applications. Bioceramics, which is found application in artificial bones and teeth, electrical insulators and electronic components, refractory bricks, cutting tool inserts, cutting tool materials and coatings, spark plug barrels in automobiles, and we can find these advanced ceramics many automobile parts, and it is useful for producing many engineering components for automobiles and machineries. These advanced ceramics also used in components for gas turbines, rocket engines and melting crucibles. Alumina is an example of crucible which is used for high temperature applications. Next type is glass ceramics. As I told you, these are the type of ceramics which is produced from heat treating the glass. The main difference between a glass and glass ceramic is their crystal structure. In the case of glass, as we see, the glass is having highly amorphous structure. We will not be able to see any regularity throughout the material. But when these glasses are annealed to certain temperature, there is a possibility for formation of some crystalline regions which resulting in ceramic glasses. So a ceramic material produced by conversion of glass into polycrystalline structure through heat treatment is defined as glass ceramics. In this glass ceramics, the crystalline phase ranges from 90 to 98%, remaining being unconverted amorphous vitreous materials. Normally the grain size of this polycrystalline present in the material in the size of 0.1 to 1 micrometer, significantly smaller than the grain size of conventional ceramics. This fine crystal structure makes glass ceramic much stronger than the glass from which they are derived. Also, due to their crystal structure, glass ceramics are opaque rather than clear. So we can see some of the material is showing glassy look, which are all called as glass ceramics, which is having opaque comparing to the normal. So by using glass, a traditional ceramic, we can produce containers, cups, jars, bottles, light bulbs, laboratory glassware such as flask, beaker, glass tubing, glass fibers for insulation, fiber optics, optical glasses for lens productions. By using them, glass ceramics, which is having higher strength comparing to glass, they are all useful for producing cooking wares, heat exchangers, missile radomes. So these are all some of the outline of general applications of ceramic product, clay construction products which include bricks, clay pipes and building tiles, refractory ceramics which is fine application ceramic capable of high temperature applications such as furnace walls, crucibles and molds, cement used for construction of the road. So cement is one of the ceramic which is used in many construction applications, whiteware products such as pottery, stoneware, fine chinaware, porcelain and other tableware based on the mixture of clay and other minerals. So whiteware sanitary wares are produced by mixing the clay and other mineral wares. Glass are useful for producing bottle, glasses, lenses, window pan and light bulbs. Glass fibers, thermal insulating wool, reinforcement plastics and fiber optic communication lines, etc. Abrasives are nothing but aluminium oxide and silicon carbide which is used for grinding purpose, and cutting tool materials such as tungsten carbide, aluminium oxide and cubic boron nitrate are useful for producing cutting tool components. Glass fibers, as we discussed, it is also useful in many important areas, and ceramic insulators or fine applications include electrical transmission component, spark plugs and microelectronic chip substances. Magnetic ceramics are useful in computer memories, and particularly ferrite is a good example for a magnetic ceramic, where ferrite are the type of ceramic magnetic material used in power transformer reading and recording heads of magnetic tapes, bubble memory cores, etc. We have seen that much elaborately in the previous part of our lecture. And these ceramics are useful in nuclear industry in nuclear fuels based on uranium oxide. Bioceramics are useful in producing artificial teeth and bone, and ceramic armor systems are used to protect military personnel and equipment. So these are all only the applications of ceramics. Beyond this, we are having plenty of applications where we are using the ceramics as a integrated part of our many equipments and devices. So by understanding these ceramics much elaborately, their properties and their application, which may help us to use these ceramics much more efficiently in our advancement of science and technology. So these ceramics are playing very important role in the material science industry for the production of technologically important devices more efficiently and in the cheaper cost. Thank you.